Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. So you can see there's a change of environment. So yes, we are finally in India. Finally, oh my god, it's been a struggle really. So now we are going to explain. So Deep is right here, little camera shy. Say hi to our fans from India. So it took us long time,
around 22 hours.
Yes. Direct flight normally from Abu Dhabi to Kolkata is five and a half hours.
Four and a half hours. Coming to Kolkata, it is around 4.5 hours. While going back, it takes around 5.5.
Yeah. So that's the maximum time limit our flight can take. But unfortunately, due to this COVID situation, there was no direct flight to Kolkata. From Dubai, it's there. But for us, traveling to Dubai is a nuisance. So we opted for Abu Dhabi to Kolkata via Bombay or Delhi. So we thought maybe Delhi has fog issues, smog alerts and all. So we thought we'll not go with Delhi. So we'll go via Bombay so that it's faster to reach home. We wanted to reach home ASAP. So we had only 3.5 hours of layover in Bombay. So we knew that it's a self-check-in process. Like we have to take the collect the baggages and then check in as we do in normal flight. So we thought 3.5 hours, and as his friends also suggested who have traveled recently, they also said 3.5 hours is not a much of a layover time. So it will go pass by for us while collecting and checking ourselves in. So okay, fine. So let me tell you now from the evening. So there will be one picture I'll show you now. The number of luggages we carried. We wanted to take home gifts as
most
usual.
Of the gifts, yeah.
Yeah. So two of the trolleys are filled with gifts, and rest two trolleys are clothes which we'll wear. Some clothes that we think that we are not gonna wear here, we'll keep it at home or mom will donate. So for those, we're also carrying the extra luggage so that we can keep at home and come back. So after this, we left at home from at I think 7:15 p.m. Yeah, after we were done with our offices on a Thursday night, we left because our flight got pre-poned. It was on Friday, then it got pre-poned on Thursday night 11:55, then it again got pre-poned to 11:25 p.m. So we were praying that please let our flight not get cancelled because we have to travel. So we left at 7:15. We reached airport in 1 hour.
Usually we used to give 2 hours buffer time. This year, this time we gave it three and a half hours.
So our flight was 11:25, so we reached by 8:25. So it was like, well, 3 hours back, yeah. Only we reached. So then when we got down from the taxi, we just saw there was a long line, which was like crossing the line of the taxis in the airport. And I thought maybe these are the people who just got out of the airport and they're waiting for a taxi. Maybe like that.
The queue was so huge that we couldn't even see the end of the queue.
Oh, yes.
And initially, the persons were assisting, right? They were told, you have to go and stand at the end. Then we were shocked because we have only 3 hours left. And by the 3 hours, we have to do so many stuff, right? Security check-in, the boarding.
Yeah, and then COVID test, that negative result also they'll check. And many things are there, extra steps. Mm. So then I just went in front the gate and I asked a person who was dressed, like I could guess he was an airport authority. So I asked him like what is this queue regarding, and I don't know, he didn't respond anything. He just said, no ma'am, you just sit here. Just in front of the gate he made me sit. So that's the respect he also gives you. Gives a woman at least. So they told me, no ma'am, you just sit here. Then meanwhile Deep joined with the luggages. That was unexpected. It's okay. He asked me it's a Delhi or a Bombay flight, so we said Bombay flight, and he knew it's only 3 hours left. So he told us, okay, you can enter now. So with us also, a few of the people from the line entered. We were rushing. Then I saw it's like a snake. The line inside the airport, it's a snake because they're maintaining 2 meter distance. They're maintaining the COVID regulations, and that's why there's only a single line. So from a line, it's getting it's a Delhi flight or a Bombay flight or something else like that. Then they are dispersing. But to reach that junction where the departure is happening, it's a long queue. So we thought we are gonna miss our flight, impossible. But God's there with us. So suddenly in between we were flying in Indigo. This time connecting flights were both Indigos. So one of the Indigo persons came and was shouting like Bombay flight, and we like, I raised my hand like a child, Bombay flight. And then we could cut the long queue and he could see like 10 people were in front of us in the web check-in line. So okay, now we'll be done. It's only, it's 2 hours left. We'll be done well before the time.
Yeah.
Still, it took a lot of time because there were a lot of papers being checked. So next I'll ask Deep, because he's the person who did all these things. What are the documents that are needed if somebody wants to fly? And from us, it's like UAE to India. Please tell our viewers, what are the documents you did?
Yeah, so first of all, you have to do the ticket booking as usual. There's no change in that. Once you're done with the ticket booking, go to Air Suvidha from your laptop or mobile and register yourself by entering the passport number and the address where you're going to land and going to stay during the quarantine period.
Okay, so it should be the same one, right?
Yes. It's very simple actually, and very user friendly also. You have to just fill up some details and click on submit. Once you submit, you'll get a SR number. That is mainly the registration number. And you can keep it with you, take a printout of it. Better to take 2 or 3 copies of printout.
Definitely 2. Yeah.
Once that is done, 72 hours before the flight, make sure you have a valid negative COVID test report, which will be really handy, and it will be anyone might ask for it actually.
Yeah, and make sure to do a COVID test where you will get a printed report.
Yes.
That is definitely needed.
No SMS, yeah. No email.
Nothing will
work. A printout, because in airport you never know your internet will work or not.
And
or
it should
whatever.
Be stamped,
yeah.
Right? Some stamp should be there in the COVID report. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, and once you have the negative COVID test report, before 72 hours, which should be valid,
at least for the entire duration during your travel,
sure it is valid till the point you reach the destination. And once that is done, go to Air Suvidha again and apply for exemption. So, for our case, we were traveling to Kolkata via Mumbai. So, Mumbai authority has to give us the exemption so that we don't go for institutional quarantine or home quarantine or whatever in Mumbai.
Yeah.
To avoid that hassle, we try to apply for the exemption. And for the exemption, again, same process. You have to go to Air Suvidha, upload the, give the SR number, which you have got in the first step, that SR number. And after that, you have to upload your negative COVID report and also the passport. And once you apply, you'll again get a ER number. That is the exemption report number. And you have to wait for that exemption to come. Unfortunately for us, it got rejected. But the rejection reason was not that, nothing to be afraid of. It was clearly written that since you're traveling for connecting flights, it is not required. It will be decided in the airport itself. So no need to worry. So they told like the rejection reason is like, since you're not going outside to Mumbai, so you're going in a connecting flight. So no need to do the exemption. Once you reach the airport, show it to the concerned authorities and they will just stamp on your boarding pass. And for us, they also stamped us here, actually.
Yeah, we'll give the clippings later on.
We
will tell that story.
Now it's gone, actually. But it was written that we are transiting from Middle East or Europe. It was a generic stamp.
Yeah.
So we were good. We finished, I think, everything on time. But unfortunately, I think that part.
Yeah, but these are the documents, right, which are needed. Nothing else than this, right?
I think that's it, yeah.
That's it. So yeah, these are the document parts. Now we'll start.
Yeah, one more thing, sorry.
Okay.
Also, you have to install the Arogya Setu app. You are an iOS user or Android, you can get it in your stores. And just install it. Your Bluetooth should be on. And once you land in Indian airports, make sure your Bluetooth is on and your app is installed and whatever. Like, it will ask for your mobile number, Indian mobile number. You have to enter the OTP and that's it. You are set.
Yeah, and I will also suggest that to recharge your Indian number with a data pack before you leave from here, because there might be some issues with the airport Wi-Fi and something, and you might need to present any document which is not handy with you. So it's better to have a recharge, data card recharge on your phone, Indian number. So yeah, now we'll start with the story.
Yeah, so now it's the story time. So as we started, we left at 7:15, we reached 8:30, there was a line, and then we went inside and our check-in, everything was done by 10:30 p.m. So we were in front of our gate, desired gate. So we are still in between flights, we are seeming like that because we are very tired. So So that, let's come to the actual part. We roamed a bit in the airport. We'll give some clippings now of the airport that we captured and I loved a lot. I cannot omit it. Clippings of Abu Dhabi airport at night. It was kind of not empty, that portion was empty. So then we sat in front of our gates and there were very few people, like maybe 30-40 people. So we thought, okay, fine, the flight won't be so filled. We're very happy. Then during the check-in we got an SMS that it's again back to 11:55 p.m. the flight timing. Said, okay, fine, it's original, we will still have some time, because even if they fly late, they will definitely make us reach in Mumbai on time. So our Indian time to reach Bombay was 4 a.m. 4 to 4:30 a.m. they will land us. So we have, and our next connecting flight from Bombay to Kolkata was 7:30 a.m. Indian time. So we thought, okay, 3 hours we have, it was 4, because 3.5 hours we had delivered. So it's fine, so 4:30, 3 hours we'll have enough time to flight. Then suddenly we are seeing that it's 11:45. Normally 30-40 minutes before the boarding starts, there was no boarding. So we were like, I told you, please go and ask the person who is standing, please go and ask. He went finally and the person could not give any answer to them. He's like, I'm from Etihad, sorry sir, Indigo people will come and will let you know. Thought, okay, Indigo people will come. Half an hour passed by and there is no announcement when the flight will depart. Till when is the delay? Is it going to be cancelled or not? We were all like literally dying inside out of tension that will the flight be cancelled or not. Then after seeing him, and again he went for the second time, many people came and they started asking questions and they were giving no answers, vague answers, they are people. Obviously they were also helpless, but there should be a proper connection.
There's no communication actually. Like,
no communication.
Usually when you wait in the airport or when some delay happens, normally announcement comes saying that what is the reason and be patient or whatever. There's no communication from any side. And Etihad, basically they are a very good service provider, but in this case they were helpless because they told like we are not the authority here, so we have to wait for Indigo staff to come and brief you guys. And we kept waiting and one guy told like the counter is not yet closed. That was shocking part, because usually the counter gets closed once all the people comes inside and they stop the counter
45 minutes before. You cannot board. Still we didn't know the exact reason, but we were guessing. We saw people who were freshly coming with documents, set of documents, and then they told us this check-in is still going on and it's 12:30.
And in between one funny thing happened. I was just checking the Indigo flight status online and it showed departed. It showed the flight has departed and it's on time.
It's on time. We were discussing about all the passengers, we were all discussing with whom did it depart?
All of us were sitting there.
And then one person called the Indian customer care center. Then tell what the reply was given.
The guy who called the Indian customer care of Indigo, he told, sir, You have missed the flight, because I can see in system it has already departed and there's no issue from our side. Then we were like, it departed with whom? Because all of us are sitting there.
All the passengers, and that time it was full. People were not even getting place to sit. Yeah, but still they were maintaining one place gap between each seat. That was mandatory in Abu Dhabi airport. So then suddenly after the ruckus we created, then we got an update, SMS or email update I think from Indigo, that the flight is postponed to 1 a.m. We were definitely sure, because it was already 12:40 when we got the update at 1 a.m. that it is delayed. It is 12:40, the boarding should start. There is no way the boarding started. Then maybe nearly around 11:55 or something, the people, Indigo people came, two people.
12:50.
Yeah, 1 o'clock, no?
12:40, yeah. 12:40 I saw some people are coming.
Yeah, yeah. But the Indigo people, they came and then the boarding started after 1 o'clock. Now, at least the flight is not cancelled.
Yeah.
But the second tension that we had was, will we be able to catch the connecting flight or not? how is this possible? We are asking them the questions and they're saying they will put you on the next flight if you if there is any problem. We were expecting the 7:30 flight will at least delay for some minutes because we that time also we thought that maybe Indigo flight didn't come. There was a delay from Indigo side. We were all confused because we were not sure till then. But then when the boarding happened, everything, the flight started at 1:40 a.m. finally. So then the air hostess came and said that they were waiting in the airport for 3 hours. Yeah. Like Indian time, 10:30 they reached. So but whatever, they waited for 3 hours for us to come in. So there was a delay from Abu Dhabi airport due to all these COVID guidelines. So nothing to do, we were praying in the entire flight that I couldn't sleep. Just praying that so that I can catch the flight. Finally, I think at 5:30 or 5:45 Indian time, we thought maybe we can still board it. But the captain was given instruction to land on a particular place. When he landed, the airport authority again said, no, it's not the place. Wait, a car will come and guide you somewhere else. For that, we waited again for maybe 20-25 minutes, 30 minutes for sure. And I'm like, oh my god, we are losing money, but what is it? Time is more now, efficient than money. Like, okay, that's it.
The flight managed to pull it off, like, we saw a ray of hope, you can say, that okay, we can still make it. But that time, the captain told, like, the traffic control. They have told him to land in some bay area and later on advised to move to some other area.
Yeah. And so, I will insert some clippings of us in between in the Abu Dhabi to Bombay flight. I got the middle seat and I had to wear PP kit. So I was already feeling suffocating and then there was the face shield also, face mask also.
So face shield was for everyone.
For everyone.
And only the guy who was sitting in the middle
had to wear the full PP kit. So here you'll see the images of us. So okay, after this, after then we landed, whatever happened, then we had to walk like for minimum 20 to 30 minutes to reach our baggage counter. We ran like hell. I think we sweated after a long time because the running time is AC, but still we were sweating. Yeah, so then after we landed and we walked for 30 minutes, we reached our baggage counter. We ran like hell. We reached over there and normally luck was not favoring us. So we thought again, we have to wait here for so long time. And suddenly I saw a bag and I'm like, okay, that can't be mine. Never ever, because we get our luggages on the first go. Deep said, no, this is our luggage. It's fine. But we had like two big trolleys and one small trolley in the check-in luggage. So the small trolley we got. I said, yeah, okay, fine. We have to wait for two more trolleys and damn sure we'll take more half an hour here. Suddenly, he also saw one of the big pink trolleys came. That's it. Okay, fine. I never took it. Again, after 30 seconds, we saw our blue trolley. Then, okay. Then when we got all the three trolleys now, we were looking at each other. Okay.
How come it's possible?
No, we were thinking, okay, we have to wait for some more time because it's not possible. Then we realized both at the time that, yeah, we got our luggages. Then immediately we started running again because we had many more formalities like the immigration and then there was
one. The exemption report.
Where he told you previously the stamp and everything. Then we got it done also and we requested like to have a flight like that in 1 hour. It was very smooth, luckily, and we got everything cleared.
Yeah.
But
when we reached like exact boarding where we have to check in for the next IndiGo flight, they said, ma'am, the boarding has already closed and you cannot board anymore. And
After doing so much things, we
missed our flight, guys. We missed our flight. So
it's like losing a cricket match by one run.
Yeah, so we missed our flight. Then, so when we asked them for the next possible option, they said there are 12 p.m. directly. They said there's a direct flight, and he was like, no, 12 p.m. is too late. What's the next available option? And then they said it's 8:30 a.m. and it's via Bangalore, so you're going to eventually reach at 1:30 to 2 o'clock, and if you take the 12 p.m. flight, you're going to reach by 2:30.
Yeah, so it's a 1 hour difference.
Yeah, then I said immediately, no, I can never go anymore via. Yeah. God knows, even Bangalore, then we go, and then again we miss the flight.
Again we'll miss the flight, and again they'll tell, okay, let's go to, Hyderabad.
Yeah, then go to Delhi, then we'll start roaming entire India, we'll not be able to reach Kolkata. They said, no more chances, we'll wait. Then our 3.5 hours turned into 7 hours from that time. We were dog tired. We couldn't wait anymore. We couldn't stand. We couldn't sit. What to do next? And we thought, okay, how many cards do you have? Take out all your cards. You want to go to a lounge. So luckily, the good lounge had...
For me, actually, most of the cards are local, UAE cards. So I was not sure if they will accept it in Indian airports. But luckily I had Citibank card, which is valid all over the world, globally. Yeah. And also I had one Axis card, which was a pretty good card, and it was covered actually in the GVQ lounge.
GVQ,
so
yeah.
GVK.
So we'll insert the clippings around it. It was lovely.
Thank you.
the clippings for from our lounge extra visit. So we had a little bit of breakfast. We were tired even to eat, but just whatever we took, little bit we ate. I finally could close my eyes for 10 minutes over there because it was a sofa and it was comfortable. So I had to close my eyes, and but we couldn't sleep anyhow. And I could never ever imagine that after like reaching, I could ever use the word jet lag after traveling from Abu Dhabi to Kolkata. Yeah, because it's normally quite fast. So whatever. So we stayed there for till 11, I think, right? Till 11, and then we left because we didn't want to create any more.
And in between, I was going and checking like, is the flight on time or not? Yeah. Is it cancelled or not? Yes. Because you know, suddenly when I went to washroom.
He called me.
I could hear some announcement going on that this flight has been cancelled. Kolkata flight got cancelled, and luckily it was not Indigo, it was SpiceJet, and some other flights also got delayed and cancelled. The Delhi flights, because Delhi was having massive fog that day.
So you had a correct prediction of not going by Delhi.
Delhi was a lot of fog was and a lot of flight got cancelled, whichever were connecting via Delhi or something. So luckily for us, our flight was not from Delhi and it was on time. So from beginning itself till the end, it showed on time.
So then we left and we sat near the boarding. Our boarding was on time. Flight left but little late, 5-10 minutes.
It's acceptable.
But we were supposed to reach at 2:30. We entered Kolkata air by 2:15 PM. But the captain then again told us that the runway was full and minimum we have to wait for 15 to 30 minutes. Yeah. And then I could feel like the plane is going
it's just doing time pass, rounds and rounds.
And our Vinod could track like he has an app where he can track. He's saying it's going over here, then it's coming, then it's going in loops and it's coming back and everything. That was for half an hour. And we were like restless, like that's it, please land karado. That's what happened. And then we finally landed in Kolkata, I think around 3 PM. But again, luck did not favor us. We had to take the bus. We did not get directly access to the airport. So we had to take the bus and then go to the airport. We ran. Yes. So we ran, took our luggage.
But good thing is, like in Mumbai, we already cleared the customs and all. So since it's an international flight and the first entry point was in Mumbai airport, so custom clearance, everything we got from Mumbai itself. So we didn't have to waste time in Kolkata for, immigration and customs.
Yeah.
So directly we landed, we collected our baggage and we came out.
Then we booked Ola. We couldn't find an SUV because we had a lot of baggage.
Yeah, we needed an SUV. So I think Shreya first, I think she didn't get an SUV.
I went to first station and booked the prime sedan.
So the sedan came also on time, and when we tried to load it, we realized immediately that it's not going to work out. So we cancelled it.
Luckily, we thought that oh my god, let me show some mercy to them, and then SUV it was available. Otherwise, it was showing no SUVs.
Yeah.
Then SUV is available.
Because it's a prime time it's the morning hours and peak time.
No, it was afternoon. We were supposed to reach in the morning.
I was losing
track. And by the way, this is the second day. So after that day, we could not realize what is morning, what is evening, like what is going on. If you ask him a time, he will tell different time. Like not even related to the time zone.
Yeah.
And that's happening till now.
Yes.
So that was our experience. And guys, I will suggest a few tips which I'll suggest is, please take long layover if you're flying via connecting flight.
Yes.
Do not take 3 to 4 hours layover because it will pass in a jiffy. It will pass. So don't take. Keep excess documents, copies with you guys, because they might take at each point, they might ask.
And one tip is always keep a pen with you.
Yes.
Because you will not find a pen anywhere in
the
airport.
They will ask you to fill some forms in the plane.
Yes.
And they will not provide you any pen. So for that, you will have
you
a
have
headache.
To run around.
Yeah, collecting pens. And it's better not to touch anyone else's pen during this time.
Yeah.
So always carry one pen per person.
Yeah. And
you.
Also, keep some photocopies of all the documents. Like
totally.
Anytime
yeah.
they might collect it.
Yeah.
So better to have some extra copies.
Yeah, so these are the things, and if you have any lounge card access, definitely take it because you might need it.
You might need it anyway.
Yeah, we thought that we have only 3 hours flyover, we'll not need it, and he was not going to take all those cards. Luckily, he took it. Thank God.
Yeah.
So yeah, these are the few tips, and if you're traveling, we wish you a very happy journey. Hope you have liked our today's experience in story time. Please do comment and let us know if you have traveled or want to travel in the future. We can definitely help you guys in any kind of doubt you have. And please like and subscribe.
Yes.
And stay tuned for more videos, because we're in India and we are gonna shoot like hell.
Yes.
Yes. Bye.
Bye.